Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Thank you for all your subscription, like, share and comments. Nevertheless, thank you for visiting my channel this morning, afternoon or evening, whatever time you're watching the video. As you watch it, may help you. Today I want to just share with you a topic or a tip for your academic success, which is how to study smarter part 2. The part 1 is in one of my videos, my previous videos, so go ahead and watch, share and like it. Don't be blessed alone, share the blessing with others. And as you listen to this part 2, may it help you and give you a bonus and give you a boost in your academic studies and help you to have excellent grades. And I just have 2 points for you for today. Those are the 2 points on how to study smarter part 2 for this video. And as you listen, may it help you. And the first point I have for you for today is, without wasting much of your time, is Pareto principle. What does this mean? It is also called the 80-20 rule. It suggests 80% of your outcome, which results in 20% of the courses. In an academic field of study, it can mean that 80% of your grades come from 20% of your study. So make sure you prioritize 20% of your study. When studying, there are some things you do that might not directly help you while reading. And examples of those things are, they are also called the 80% of studying. And examples of those things are background reading, completing homeworks, assignments, or projects. And while studying, there are some things that directly helps you. They are called the 20% of studying. And what are the examples are? Answering past paper questions, summarizing those bulky lecturer's notes, those notes you've copied in the class, you summarize them, those bulky notes in economics, chemistry, you summarize them to the level you understand. And that does not mean that the 80% studying technique is not needed, but is not directly needed. But this 20% is the main thing when studying. And when you are able to maximize this 20% of studying, answering past paper questions, summarizing lecturer's notes, those bulky notes, you summarize them in the way you understand better, it will help you to study smarter and give you higher grades in an exam. And point 2, which is the last point for today, is Feynman technique. What does this mean? This simply means reading a book and rewriting it in a simpler form for better understanding. It involves teaching the concepts of what you have just learned to someone who doesn't have any idea of what you're teaching. So to get better understanding daily, to understand this technique daily, you have to keep on repeating this technique of teaching someone who doesn't have any idea of what you're teaching. You could be a university student and you're teaching a basic 6 student what you have read. And if you continue repeating this technique, it will help you very much. Because when you read a book, those bulky notes, and you are able to rewrite them in ways you will understand better, when you get to the exam hall and you are asked a question and it came out from that book, when you write it in your own words, the lecturer will understand that you know what he taught you, and due to the bulkiness of the note, you wrote it in a way that will be simpler for him to understand and for you also you to understand, and by that he will mark you well, and at the end of the day you score higher grades. So with these 2 points today, I know it has blessed you very well. And please, before I go, if you're new on my channel and you haven't yet subscribed, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel right away and click on the post notification bell icon so that you'll be the first person to get notified when I upload a new video. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for viewing. Please share, watch, like, comment, and literally subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you once again for listening and watching. Remain blessed. See you guys in my next video. Bye for now.